But first, it's an image already etched in the history books. Donald Trump raising his fist in the wake of an assassination attempt, transforming a moment of vulnerability into strength. But now, as both Biden and Trump navigate the political aftershocks, will that moment change the course of the presidential race?
His initial reaction after being shot will be an iconic moment in American history. Literally bleeding from a gunshot wound, he raised his fist. Don't give up, keep going.
The attempted assassination of Donald Trump, upending an already volatile presidential race.
They're gonna do whatever they can to get rid of Trump.
All I know is that for sure he's gonna win now. This ain't gonna take him down.
Well, I think it'll solidify the support for President Trump. I think his numbers will go through the roof, and leading into the convention, I think it will rocket, skyrocket.
With fears of further political violence, today President Biden called for calm.
The political record in this country has gotten very heated. It's time to cool it down.
His re-election campaign robbed of its main line of attack.
Trump is a threat to this nation.
Urgently pivoting, the Biden camp suspended its attack ads on Trump, as Republicans accused the Democrats of fanning the flames.
Look, President Biden himself said in recent days it's time to put a bullseye on Trump.
The victim, Trump, also accused of being part of the problem.
Mr. Trump uses from time to time violent language. He is, of course, responsible, at least in part, for the January the 6th insurrection.
One unknown, how Trump will respond. The former president earlier posting it was God alone who prevented the unthinkable from happening.
It'll inject that sort of almost mythical stature for Donald Trump, you know, this idea of manifest destiny, the idea that he's been spared by God for a reason.
Trump landing in Wisconsin to attend this week's Republican convention.
If he's really politically savvy, this is a prime opportunity for Donald Trump to bring the nation together.
Due to take the stage on Thursday to accept his party's nomination, Trump says he's reworked his speech. His new focus, national unity.
Perhaps he realizes that some of the things he has done have come home to roost, so to speak. But at the same time, he's just such an unknown. He's such a wild card in terms of how he chooses to play this.
So will Trump's near miss hand him the keys to the White House?
We are live from the lands of the Kulin Nation, and Steve Clemons is our man for all things US politics. Steve, the election is still 4 months away, but do you think that all of this is going to change its course?
Well, it certainly basically strengthens Donald Trump's hands going into the Republican convention right away. I mean, it's hard to imagine, you know, more stagecraft. If this were a movie or a TV show, this is an unbelievable moment. Donald Trump waving his hand in the air defiantly. And so there is that element of it. And, you know, maybe both sides will dial it down when it comes to rhetoric. But I think fundamentally, I'm one who sees the character, the different visions that Biden and Trump present are going to remain, you know, very high octane. I don't think you're going to get a kind of dialing down of that.
So you think that the rhetoric that Trump may be putting out there, I mean, he started to talk about unity, but you're not really quite buying it?
Well, I'm not. I mean, I see that there are rumors that Donald Trump is changing his campaign speech. I think there's an opportunity here for both sides to stop calling each other criminals and the end of life as we know it. But that doesn't seem to be something that, you know, seeing the Donald Trump we've known for many, many years right now, that's not exactly his shtick. And basically trying to sort of define himself as the person taking an angry America into its next phase, I think is going to be part of this. And I think for a lot of Democrats, they look at what Donald Trump represents to them by way of what the impact he may have on the constitutional order is a very serious one. So I think people are deluding themselves if they think that toxicity and tension are just going to go away because of this incident. I don't think so at all.
Steve, you can only imagine what the back room of Biden's camp thought yesterday when that all unfolded on live television. And their whole campaign's now been upended. I mean, Joe Biden can't now go out and attack Donald Trump in the way he has previously. They have to rip up all those ads they've spent millions of dollars on. What are they going to do?
Well, I mean, I think the course got a lot narrower for them. You know, I think that they have an opportunity to still sort of talk about the substantive, deep you know, tectonic differences between what they represent and what Donald Trump represents. And they're going to have to do that in language, I assume, because they want to continue to be seen as the nice guys, not as the ones that are talking about American carnage that Donald Trump might bring. But I think at the end of the day, President Biden has got to come out and sort of begin to look at what does Donald Trump represent, and rather than calling him a criminal with, you know, many felony counts against him, et cetera, he's got to basically say, this is what this guy stands for in just sober language. I don't know if they'll be able to do that, because I think the other thing that they have a big problem for is Donald Trump is waving his fist in the air after a bullet just took, you know, hit his ear, while Joe Biden's problem is looking vigorous and looking awake and looking energetic, and the contrast of those is going to be in people's minds.
Imagine if staying awake was your biggest challenge in becoming the president of the United States. Steve, we're going to have to leave it there. Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you, Waleed. Thank you.